While you might think of a stroke as a concern only for the elderly, you should know that strokes can happen to anyone at any age, at any time. Recognizing the signs of a stroke and taking action quickly can literally save a life. That's why our next two guests are hoping to improve the odds by sharing some useful information with us today. Dr. Jeffrey Boyle is a neurologist and director of the Avera McKinnon Stroke Center, and Ellen Gulbranson is a nurse and the Avera McKinnon Stroke Coordinator. Welcome.
Hi. Thanks for having us.
Thanks for having us.
Thanks for joining me today. So, Dr. Boyle, I'm going to start with you. Mm-hmm. What happens when someone has a stroke?
Well, the first thing that really makes us think, okay, somebody's going through a stroke, is that it's sudden in onset, that the symptoms just come out of nowhere. Somebody's in their normal state of health, feeling great, and then suddenly, they develop weakness or trouble talking. You know, the sudden in onset is really the first thing that we think about.
And we just mentioned that this can happen to anyone. So, Dr. Boyle, what are some causes for a stroke to occur?
Well, there's different kinds of stroke. The two major classes are called ischemic and hemorrhagic. So, hemorrhagic strokes are when a blood vessel ruptures and blood goes into the brain and causes the brain not to work and gives somebody neurologic symptoms. The more common kind of stroke is an ischemic stroke, where a clot comes from an artery or a heart, or an artery closes off in the brain, and the brain doesn't get the blood it needs, the sugar it needs, the oxygen it needs, and then symptoms can develop that way.
So, Ellen, let's go through some of these signs and symptoms, and we have BFAST. What exactly is BFAST?
Well, BFAST is an acronym that we use to help you remember what the signs and symptoms of a stroke are, and then what to do if you recognize the signs and symptoms of stroke in yourself or somebody that you're with. So we can run through it. So B stands for balance. So if you have a sudden change in your balance, if you feel really dizzy, if you can't walk in a straight line, that can be a sign that you're having a stroke.
All right, do you want to take E, Dr. Boyle?
Sure. So sudden eyesight loss, so your vision, it becomes very blurry suddenly, and or you lose vision. Even double vision can be a sign of stroke if it comes on suddenly.
Right, and F?
And then we have F, which would be a change in your face. So that would be facial drooping on one side, so have that muscle weakness on one side, or any change in your sensation, so a numbness, tingling, a heavy feeling on one side of your face.
All right.
A is for arm weakness. So if the arm becomes clumsy or heavy, people will wake up and have trouble brushing their teeth or brushing their hair, and that's a sign to get some help.
All right, and S.
S stands for speech. So if you have any changes in your speech, that would be you can't get out the words that you want to say, you can't understand words that are being said to you, or if you have slurred speech suddenly, that can be a sign of a stroke as well.
And last, we have T.
So this is really just to remind us of what the next step is. So if you have any of these symptoms and are suspicious for a stroke, call 911. Don't drive if you're having a stroke, because you can have an accident, and especially if you're not seeing something on one side, you can have an accident. And so call 911. We can check your blood sugar, we can check your blood pressure, and do things initial, have initial assessments to get you the best care that you need.
If I'm a bystander to someone having a stroke, is there anything that I can do?
I think just call 911 is the first thing to do. Some people say you have to take an aspirin when you're having a stroke, or take an extra dose, and you know, if it's the bleeding kind of stroke, then that would be the wrong thing to do. So we generally don't say take an aspirin when you have a sign of a stroke, until we do a CT scan, and then we can see if there's blood or not, and then that's when we decide if it's a bleeding kind of stroke or a clot kind of stroke.
Okay. And Ellen, let's go through the risk factors.
Sure. So the risk factors for stroke you can see on your screen are diabetes, high blood pressure, and high cholesterol are the top three that we really talk about. Excessive use of alcohol puts you at higher risk of stroke, and then a history of heart disease. And then there are some lifestyle changes that you can make to help to manage these risk factors. Obesity, a lack of exercise, and smoking all contribute to those risk factors. So really trying to stay on top of having a healthy lifestyle, taking your medications as appropriate, and being aware of your own risk factors and the ways that you can control those risk factors are the best things you can do to prevent a stroke.
And Dr. Boyle, when it comes to medications, what should we be doing as far as risk factors go?
Well, talk to your doctor about, taking medications anytime that you feel like you need a change in medications or read something. There was something in the news recently about people that take aspirin should, at an advanced age with no risk factors. Do they really need aspirin? It does present a risk for excessive bleeding and, bleeding in the stomach and that sort of thing. So if you have no risk factors, there is there are some physicians who will take you off aspirin at an older age. And, I've had several patients come to the clinic and say, and patients I've seen in the emergency department with stroke, say, I stopped my aspirin because the news told me to. And the news is wonderful. Let me tell you, I love the station. I love what news can give us, but it's not a physician. And really, you got to talk to your doctor about any change in your medication. So.
And when patients do arrive in the ER, how do you help them when they have just experienced a stroke?
Like I said, we do a CT scan to really see what kind of stroke it is. And then after that, depending on what that is, and if you get in fast, be fast, right? If you get in fast, then we can give you a clot buster, or thrombolytic is the word. And so, there's not a lot of cures in medicine, right? Things, we treat things, it seems like. But as far as, as close to a cure as we can get is if I can take this clot and I can break it up, or I can get, move it or get rid of it, that your symptoms may resolve. You may have no symptoms. And, when you see it for the first time, and you're, a young doctor or you're in your training and somebody, you say, oh man, this is a terrible stroke. They're going to end up in a nursing home, I'm sure of it. And then they suddenly start moving their arm or leg. I mean, it's just the chills in your spine to see them move. It's just amazing. And so, that happens. It's not common, but when it does, it's just so rewarding. And so get in the emergency room. If you can get the medicine, then we'll give it to you and see what happens. So.
All right. Thank you both so much for coming in and sharing this information with us.
Thank you.
Yeah. Thanks for having us.
You can count on the quick response and expertise you'll find at all 330 Avera locations across South Dakota, Minnesota, Iowa, Nebraska, and North Dakota, where more than 850 professionals are dedicated to providing you and your family with patient-focused care.